Thank you very much for tuning in. Hope you are having a very nice day. Today, before getting into our topic, I would like to share with you one of the tools that will help us in our academic and personal lives. You can skip this part and go to where today's main video starts. Or you can hear this first and find something you have always been searching for. Well, in Dr.Ceutica Tube, we aim not only at helping with pharmaceutics and related science, but we do also care for self-care for learning. So today, we will share with you something to use whenever you feel distracted and not present in any situation, including your study sessions. When you have feeling of an unknown anxiousness and you are thinking a million direction, take a deep breath and acknowledge 5 things you can see in the surrounding and 4 things you can touch, 3 things you can hear, 2 things you can smell, and 1 thing you can taste. By that, you will drag yourself out of that nowhere to where you really are, and you will regain your focus. Give it a try and let us know of your experience in the comments down below. Now, without any further ado, let's get started. Okay, today we are going to talk about solubility. This topic mainly resides under physical pharmaceutics, yet it projects nearly to all branches of pharmaceutics in a way or another. We put the links of the videos for all pharmaceutics branches in the description box below to make it easier for you to reach. So, what is solubility? Well, solubility is a property of a matter called solute, whether that matter is solid, liquid, or a gas. To dissolve in a solid, liquid, or a gas matter, that is termed solvent, and form a homogeneous solution of the solute in the solvent. So, the solute is dissolved in the solvent to make the solution. A quite common example that is used here is the salt water. The salt that is the solid solute is dissolved in the water, which is a liquid solvent, to form salt water solution. In pharmacy, the solvent is generally a liquid. It can be one liquid or more. We also have solid solutions, which we will deal with later, yet in a quite rare cases, we might also have solution in a gas. Okay, so how solubility is determined? Well, solubility is understood chemically as a maximum amount of solute that dissolves in a certain solvent at equilibrium. Equilibrium is the state where reactants and products reach a balance. And here it means that dissolution, the process of the solute going into solution, and the reverse process of the solute coming out from the solution, which can be precipitation for solids, are in equilibrium. To put it in simpler words, solubility is determined when no more solute can be dissolved in a certain solvent in a specific set of conditions of temperature and pressure. If you take 1 liter of water and start dissolving the salt, NaCl, in that water at a temperature of 25 degrees centigrade and an atmospheric pressure of 1, you should be able to dissolve exactly 357 grams. If you added any more salt, it won't dissolve and will stay at the bottom of the container. So simply, that means the solubility of an ACL is 357 grams per liter at 25 degrees centigrade and 1 atmospheric pressure. Now we know what solubility is and how it is determined. For pharmaceutical substances, how do we express solubility? Do we say it like X is soluble in Y or insoluble in it? Well, actually, if we want to be scientifically speaking, we would adopt the USP, the United States Pharmacopeia, and the British Pharmacopeia, which are the main compendia we refer to. These two compendia designate the extent of solubility by 7 descriptive terms. The terms are very soluble, freely soluble, soluble, sparingly soluble, slightly soluble, very slightly soluble, and practically insoluble. We describe a substance by one of these terms depending on the number of parts of solvent required to dissolve one part of a solute. If we needed less than 1 milliliter of water to dissolve 1 gram of substance, that substance is considered very soluble. Yet, if we needed 100 to 1000 milliliters for the 1 gram, then we call that substance slightly soluble. And if more than 10,000 milliliters fail to dissolve the 1 gram of a substance, then that substance is practically insoluble in that certain solvent. About 90% of drugs we take are administered orally. Those drugs have to pass from the GIT or get absorbed to the blood circulation through which they reach to the site of action. It's a rule of thumb that for any drug to be absorbed, it must be in the form of a solution at the site of absorption, which makes solubility one of the important parameters to attain the desired concentration of the drug in the blood circulation for achieving the desired response. And that is not only for oral dosage forms, but nearly for all dosage forms. If you felt lost at this point, kindly check the Biopharmaceutics video. I will put the link in the description box below and we will become on the same page again. It's quite interesting to know that about 40% of new chemical entities are practically insoluble in water. Water, the solvent found in our human bodies. With that poor aqueous solubility, such drugs will pose challenges in absorption, bioavailability, and imparting the desired effect. Thus, they would need extra cost and time to be incorporated in effective formulations that are not needed to be frequently administered in high doses. Scientists use various techniques for solubility enhancements. These techniques can fall into 2 broad categories. Those are physical modification and chemical modification. Of course, we will dive deeper into this in the future, but this video comes to an end here. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit the like button and consider subscribing. Here is a quick recap of what has been said. You can take a screenshot and look at it later. To put our topic today into practice, go and check the solubility of sodium chloride and NaCl or any other chemical at Pubchem. I will put the link in the description box so you can get familiar with seeing the different expressions of solubility. Now you know what each part is about and how it was driven. Don't forget to share your comments down below, and as always, stay fabulous wherever you are.